like the video and subscribe right now, and Lion Doggo will never attack you. Why did that teacher get fired from your school? Students laughed she ate toothpaste. Turns out she was an alcoholic trying to cover her breath. 9 out of 10 alcoholics recommend Crest TM. Female PE teacher. She got caught sniffing a girl's underwear while she was showering. Imagine getting out of the shower and seeing your teacher with her nose in your ducking underwear. WTF is wrong with people? Two teachers. They got caught ducking in a classroom. My 5th grade teacher got caught ducking the IT dude in her classroom while we were out for recess. Neither got fired, but were transferred to other schools. My math teacher was a volunteer first responder in New York. She left school to help out during 9/11 and was fired for not showing back up for 2 weeks. Ducking hell. The students and parents fought for her, but I think she decided not to come back because of the outright ducked upness. Dating a 16-year-old female student. He was also a PE teacher. Edit. I should clarify that he did do jail time and is on the Shrek's offenders register. It's always the PE teachers. This one is actually sort of rather sad. Had an amazing but eccentric math teacher who was incredibly involved with helping students. He made sure to always cover his bases, so there was nothing really creepy about him. The year I left high school, was a senior at this time, went on to finish my JED, he was fired. Shortly after news an article that he had killed himself with a self-inflicted gunshot. What had happened during this period of time was a student had come forward to the administration and accused him of sexual misconduct, both of them being males, and unfortunately there was no real way to prove a negative for the missing time outside of school hours, so they promptly let him go. Being a gay, black, teacher in South Texas, rough. He wrote a letter basically denying all of the accusations, but had come to the grim realization that at his age, his career was effectively over, so he shot himself in the head. Later the student who made the accusations came forward and said he had fabricated the entire event because he was failing his grades and angry. The whole event was quietly swept under the rug. RIP Mr. Ethan. You were a good person who was cut down by others' selfishness. One of my high school teachers was caught on to catch a predator. I bet it was Walter Babst, the high school teacher from Riverside, California. Bingo. You guessed it. I haven't watched the video in years. He was a wonderful, friendly and handsome teacher. This girl had a crush. Some bitch told the teacher about this girl's crush. The teacher felt awkward and avoided her eyes from then on. Girl got hurt. Complained to the principal that he was being creepy with her. All the heads, which included my father, were called for a meeting with him. He got sick of defending himself. Shouted, "Duck you," and left the school. They fired him before he could hand out his resignation. Edit. To clarify some things, it was one of the best schools and all the richy rich kids studied there. I studied because my father was a faculty. Otherwise we don't have so much money, and hence teachers were dealt with very harshly. On one occasion, a teacher was fired only because it seemed on the cameras that he hit a boy hard. The parents complained, and he was fired the next day without listening to him at all. My father knew that he just patted him, but the kid was spoiled and he lied. Also, the teacher was a junior one. Nothing happened to the girls. Bauer Reich might have talked to them about it, but IDK about that. They graduated fine. No problem. I got to know about this incident later. When I was there, I just knew that he knows she has a crush on him and that he left one day. I mentioned my father so that you'll know how I know what happened in the meeting. He just knew that a girl has complained, and now they are called. Also, the teacher we are talking about was every student's favorite. So other teachers were jealous, and they all assumed he is very lenient, and encourages us to not follow other teachers and stuff. So it might have made it hard for him to say he stayed professional always. She had fallen off the wagon, and was drinking a lot to the point where it was affecting her memory. We kept doing the same lecture on density in 6th grade science for a month, until one of my classmates decided to ask another teacher about it. From there she went to rehab. Your knowledge on density must be phenomenal. Do not fear the man who has learned 1000 concepts once, but the man who has learned one concept 1000 times. One of the elementary school teachers at the district I went to got arrested for making his class worship him, like he was a cult leader. He was totally bonkers. What the duck? I don't know whether to laugh or be shocked. This is the weirdest one yet. Yeah, we all knew he was really odd, but I never expected him to start making the class call him master, and making them say that he was a higher power. The principal of my elementary school got fired the first year he was hired, or took leave, before he was arrested. I'm not actually sure which came first. So a couple kids in my 4th grade class thought they'd prank the science teacher by pouring iodine and bleach into his coffee when he wasn't looking. The teacher tasted it as soon as the drink hit his tongue and immediately spit it out. He grilled the class and the kids admitted to it and got sent to the principal's office. The principal found out which of them physically poured the chemicals into the coffee, then took him into the bathroom to discipline him, hit him. Apparently he grabbed the bottom of his jaw while screaming in his face. You could hear him echoing through the hallway. Then he squeezed hard enough that the boy started crying. So he slapped him across the face and told him to stop crying. The kid's dad was a lawyer, BTW. Suddenly cops were in the building and our new principal was out the door. Edit, along with the kids who poisoned the coffee. My high school of 500 students lost 5 teachers last year because they all had a relationship with the same 15Y/a girl. Is this real? Sadly, the story is that this girl started flirting with all her male teachers to get attention and good grades, and they all flirted back and sent her nudes and stuff. Then at the end of the year, when she realized how ducked up it was, she exposed them to the whole school. One was such an unlikable teacher they were asked to retire. One was watching porn in class. One sent someone else's dick pics to a student's mom. One robbed a bank. My sociology teacher in high school was fired for throwing a chalkboard eraser at a sleeping student's head. He was a great teacher and always did this in good humor. Obviously not a great idea in retrospect, but we all knew that we could get away with sleeping in his class if we didn't mind getting an eraser upside the head if he noticed. I heard he was fired a few years after I graduated high school, and that kinda bummed me out. Probably deserving of a reprimand of some sort, but not getting fired. It's not like he was a Shrek's offender or guitar player. You just stuck the landing with your last sentence, lol. Geeky AV teacher that everyone loved. Knew he was a geek and owned it. Caught in a predator sting trying to solicit underage girls. The kicker was a spring school levy was coming up. Local police conspired with the school district to hide the charges for 3 weeks until the levy was passed. Someone substituted his class for 3 weeks. Yay, everyone was both devastated and pissed. The district ended the school year early. He was playing his guitar for students at my elementary school. He had been warned before, but the kids enjoyed it, so he continued to play it for them anyways. One day, the assistant principal was lurking in the hallway and wandered to his classroom. She saw him playing his guitar and fired him on the spot. A whole lot of students were crying that day because he was an amazing guy. Edit, more information. This took place in a small rural town in Georgia back in the early 2000s. He wasn't the music teacher, he just used to bring his guitar and play songs randomly on some days and the kids enjoyed it. He'd been warned multiple times by his higher-ups, why, IDK. He was a great teacher. He thought that before the break, he could play something for us one last time during the last week of school. It just happened to be the worst possible timing, while the assistant principal was walking through the halls. He didn't come back to teach at our school when classes started again. If I recall, he got a job teaching at a different school. Explained elasticity by pulling the bra strap of a girl. Another one for having relationship with a girl from 8th grade, 14 yo. Hey sissy, come here, so I can explain the female reproduction to the class. My AP chemical teacher had an affair with the principal. Principal got fired too. I felt bad for her. They didn't do anything on school property, and it didn't impact her performance in the classroom. Also, the school wasn't able to find a qualified teacher to replace her halfway through the year, so we were all ducked. Come test time at the end of the year, not one of us passed that AP test. That's messed up. There are very few teachers in a given school that are capable of teaching AP, especially without training. Not to mention that it was a rural area where there wasn't a surplus of teachers, period, much less ones prepared for higher level courses. I don't blame the district for not being able to find an adequate replacement, but I do blame them for firing her in the first place. I heard a rumor that my favorite teacher from 9th grade got fired when I was in 10th grade because he left his class unattended. Honestly, amid all the pedophilia and rampant alcoholism, I like the anticlimax of this one. Hell, if my school was held to the same standards, we'd have no teachers left. One was fired for beating his wife and kids. Another one, assistant principal, was fired for Shreks with a student on campus in her office. Another, the principal, resigned because he knew about that and let it happen. Our new band teacher was a young guy, fresh out of college. His first year teaching, and he embezzled about $1,000 from the band's funds. He got arrested, and his possible future career ruined for $1,000. He accidentally made a really racist joke thinking the class would think it was funny. They didn't OFC, so he was fired that day. It's nice that at least your classmates didn't think it was funny. Not sure I can say the same if mine were in the same position. He straight up didn't show up to work one Monday, didn't call into a ranger sub or anything. He ghosted the school for a whole week, and then tried to come in the following Monday like nothing happened. We also had a 5th grade teacher overdose on meth, but I honestly don't know if she got fired or resigned. It didn't happen at school. TW, suicide. Our principal was escorted out by 2 police. Come to find out it was because he was caught committing fraud. He would assign students to classes without telling them to make it seem there were more kids in, let's say, the art department, so that the department would receive more funding from the government to continue. He meant well, but students caught on when we moved to college and transcripts from high school had a whole page F's or withdrawals. It really messed us up. About 2 weeks later he hung himself. Left behind a wife and kids. It really hit me hard, because I almost dropped out of high school after 2 of my friends committed suicide. He was the one that got me counseling, helped me graduate, and encouraged me to go to college. I would not be here if it weren't for him. It just really hurt to know that, while he was helping me accomplish that, he did the same thing only a month or 2 later. We planted trees for him to remember him by. RIP Mr. Woodcroft, you meant well. He got arrested driving through Nevada over the summer with 20 pounds of weed in his car that he'd bought in California. He had no intention on telling the district, and we only found out because a news reporter from the town he was arrested in contacted our superintendent for a quote on the matter. He was let go immediately. The one that for fired was a substitute teacher and coach of a girls team for grade 7-9. He seemed a bit creepy, and we joked that he liked coaching the girls and teaching PE so he could watch the girls run around in their shorts. Turns out that wasn't far from the truth. His full-time job was in the medical field, where he was caught doing inappropriate things to female patients, some of whom being kids he coached and taught, and he had 2 sons in that school. This one didn't get fired, but she was at the point where she had a few classes taken from her, and if she did anything wrong, she would have been gone. Why? Well, she didn't know the subject she was teaching, and would make stuff up, rather than admitting she didn't know the answer. She was always mad, and we called her Popsicle, because she acted like she had a stick up her ass. But the biggest thing was that she failed 2 grade 11 classes. The whole class, because apparently not one person, including the smartest people in the school, passed any tests. Had a history teacher get fired for going off syllabus and spending time on the pre-Judaic flood stories. One of maybe 2 reasons I'm obsessed with Mesopotamian/Anatolian/Egyptian history now. At first I thought you meant he was teaching the great flood Noah as history. But do you mean he/she taught about how there were similar flood stories told prior to the Judeo-Christian one? The art teacher at my middle school was known to be very suspicious. I've heard that he would take pictures of girls and touch girls. And adding to the fact that he called 2 girls lesbians in front of the whole class. It was just very weird. All these rumors, and he got fired eventually. I can't imagine how his wife must have felt when she asked why he got fired. They didn't fire him based on rumors. My money's on they had solid evidence against him, but it wasn't made public. You've been visited by the doggo of slimness. You will be blessed with slim body, but only if you comment, "Wow, you're so slim, doggo." Thanks for watching. Do not forget to subscribe for more daily videos.